हेलो एवरीवन, गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स। इन प्रीवियस क्लास वी डिस्कस अबाउट द चैप्टर कंस्ट्रक्शन, ओके। एंड इन दैट क्लास वी डिस्कस ऑल द टॉपिक ऑफ द कंस्ट्रक्शन, लाइक एज कंस्ट्रक्शन ऑफ द बाइसेक्टर ऑफ अ लाइन सेगमेंट, वी डिस्कस द कंस्ट्रक्शन ऑफ द बाइसेक्टर ऑफ एन एंगल, ओके, बाइसेक्टर ऑफ एन अ गिवन एंगल। वी डिस्कस अबाउट द construction of some standard angles as 90 degree, 45 degree, 60 degree, 30 degree with the help of ruler and compasses only. We discuss also about the construction of an angle of 45 degree. We discuss about the some construction of triangle, like we discuss about the construction of an equilateral triangle. And two most important topic of that chapter is the construction of a triangle when its base, one base angle and the sum of other two sides is given. We also discuss of that topic. Now also we discuss about the construction of triangle. Construction of triangle when base and one base angle and the difference between the other two sides is given. Okay, now dear student, we completed all the topic of that chapter. And one topic is left in that year, which is split in excluded of your topic, that is in syllabus. There is construction of a triangle of a given perimeter and two base angle. That topic is removed in that year, okay, according to CBSE curriculum. Now we discuss all the topic in that chapter, and we also discuss some questions based on each topic, okay. Now today dear student, we revise all the topic which we discuss in that chapter, okay. So today is the last class of that chapter construction, okay. And now in next class we discuss about the new chapter, that is one, and your last chapter is statistics. Now dear student, let us revise all the topic which we discuss in that chapter. So your first topic is some basic construction is construction of bisector of a line segment. We revise one by one each and every topic of that chapter. Now that chapter is completed today, okay. Now let's see. First we revise the topic construction of bisector of the line segment. Dear student, we discuss, you are already aware of this topic, about this topic, and we revise and all the topic. We discuss about the line bisector of a line segment. In that construction, dear student, first of all, you draw a line segment which is given in your question, okay. After that, what is the process of that bisector of the line segment? We take what? A as center and distance equal to more than half of AB. We take A as center and distance equal to more than half of AB. We cut the arcs on each side of the line segment AB in this way, that and this, in this way. In this way, taking A center and distance equal to the more than half of AB, we cut the two arcs on each side of the line segment AB. Okay. Now, after that, taking B as center and have the same radius, cuts the previous arc, same as we cut the previous and two distinct point in this way. And suppose that the arc cuts to each other at two distinct point M and N. Now after that you join the line MN. This is the perpendicular bisector of the line segment. Suppose that this is the point P. Now here you have AP is equal to BP, okay. So here P be the perpendicular bisector of the line segment. Here P be the point which bisects the given line segment AB into equal parts, that is AP is equal to BP. This is the process to construct a perpendicular bisector of any line segment. Now clear? Dear student, what is the process of that type of construction? Dear students, first of all you draw a line segment AB, okay. After that, taking A as center and distance equal to more than half of AB, you cut the arcs on each side of the line segment AB. Okay, after that, taking B as center and have the same radius, cuts the arcs on each side of the line segment which cuts the previous arc at two distinct points. Now after that, you join two distinct point of intersection of each arcs, and hence let's get a point P. So here P be the P bisects the given line segment in two equal part, that is AP is equal to BP. So dear student, this is the whole process of to construct the any bisector of the line segment. Okay, now we discuss your next topic of that chapter, that is the construction of the bisector of a given angle. Let's see. Now we discuss about the construction of bisector of an angle of an angle. This topic is also discussed in that class. Now today revise all the topic. Okay, today's session is all the topic is revised in that class. Now first we discuss about the construction of the perpendicular bisector of the line segment. Now we discuss about the bisector of an angle. For that type of construction, first of all, we make an angle which is given in our question. Yes. Suppose that, let's see. First of all, we have an angle BAX. This is an angle. Okay, this is an angle what BAX, and we construct the bisector of an angle BAX. Here two rays AB and AX here, and these rays are construct an angle BAX. Now we have to construct the angle the bisector of an angle BAX. Okay, let's see now what we do. Dear students, this topic is also clear in previous classes. Let's see once more time. Suppose that, dear students, this is an arc take as PQ. Here this is the angle formed an arc this PQ. Now taking P as center, dear student, we take for the angle bisector, we take A center and have the any convenient radius, draw an arc PQ. For construction the bisector of an angle, first we take A center and have the any convenient radius, you can draw an arc in this way, that is let us take an arc PQ, we construct in that. Okay, now taking P as center, after that taking P as center and distance equal to more than half of PQ. Okay, let's see. Taking P as center and distance equal to more than half of PQ, cuts an arc in this way. Okay, in the same way have the same radius, taking now Q as center and taking another arc in this way. Suppose that arcs cuts to each other at point M. Suppose that arcs intersect the point M. Now we join AM. We join AM and produce to Y. Then the angle BAY and angle XAY. Are the bisectors of an angle BAX. Okay, so dear student, that angle is always equal to each other, means that angle BAY is equal to angle XAY. Okay, so dear student, this is the whole process to construct an angle the bisector of an angle. We construct the angle bisector of an angle in that process. Let's see once more time. First we draw an angle BAX. Okay, now we taking A as center and have any convenient radius, draw an arc as PQ which cuts the two rays AB at point P and AX at point Q. Now taking P as center and distance equal to the more than half of PQ, cuts an arc. Same as taking Q as center and distance and have the same radius, cut the another arc which cuts the intersect each other at point M. Now we join AM and produce two Y. So this is the angle by bisector of an angle. Okay, now clear? Okay, now dear student, we discuss the next topic of that chapter, which is, let's see, construction of some straightened angles. Let's see. Now we discuss about the construction of some standard angles. Okay, now we discuss about the construction of some standard angles. First I am going to draw the construction of an angle 60 degrees. Suppose that in that type of construction, first of all you draw a line segment. Suppose that AB. Okay, suppose that AB. Now taking A as center and have the any convenient radius. Okay, suppose and any radius, draw an arc PQ. Suppose that, draw an arc PQ. Suppose we cut the line segment AB at point P and this is the point Q. Okay, taking A as center and have the any radius, cut an arc. Now taking P as center, and the same radius, cut an another arc PQ at R. Suppose that, have the same radius, cut an another arc at in this way. Okay, suppose that R. Now we join AR and produce to some distance. Now let's see. Now we join what? AR and produce to Y. So this angle is what? 60 degree. So that angle is equal to 60 degree. Now this is the process to construction of the angle 60 degree with the help of ruler and compasses only. Okay, dear student, this is the whole process to construct the angle of 60 degree with the help of ruler and compass. Let's see once more time. First of all, dear student, we draw a line segment AB. Okay, now after that, taking A as center and have any convenient radius, draw an arc in this way. Okay, which cuts the line segment AB. Suppose this is a ray. Which cuts the ray AB at point P. Okay, now dear students, now taking P as center and have the same radius, which is take as in this way. Okay, now taking P as center and have the same radius, cuts the arc, which cuts the previous arc PQ at point R. Okay, now after that we join AR and produce to Y. Dear student, this is the whole process to construct an angle 60 degree with the help of ruler and compasses only. Okay, now dear student, look, if we construct an angle of 30 degree, then what is angle of 30 degree? You know that when we divided by 2 by in 60, when we divided 60 by 2, then we get 30 degree. If we bisect, so we can say that if we construct an angle of 30 degree by the help of ruler and compasses, then first we draw an angle of 60 degree with the help of ruler and compasses in that way. Now after that, if we construct the bisector of that angle, so the bisector of that angle is equal to what? 30 degree. Okay, now in going to construct an angle of 30 degree, first you can draw easily the angle of 60 degree. After that, let's see, take A as the radius and and have any convenient radius, draw an arc in this way, which cuts the two previous rays AB and AY at two distinct points LM, M respectively. Okay. Now, what is the procedure to find the to construct the angle bisector? First, now we take L as center and distance equal to more than half of LM. We cut an arc in this way. Now with the have the same radius and now taking M as center, we cut the previous arc in this way. Cuts an arc. Now we join this and produce to some distance. So this is the angle of 30 degrees. So dear students, so in this way we can construct an angle of 60 degree and 45 degree with the help of ruler and compasses only. Okay. So dear student, these topics, so you can practice each and every construction in that chapter. Okay, then you can construct easily any angle with the help of ruler and compasses. Now dear student, we discuss the another topic of that chapter. Let's see, we revise another topic and your next topic is, let's see, and your next topic is construction of a triangle. Construction of a triangle when its base one base angle and the sum of other two sides is given, and the sum of other two sides is given. That topic is also very important for your syllabus, dear student. So this topic is must be revised more and more times. Okay, in that type of question, dear student, when we suppose that we take a question, let's see. Suppose that, then I revise that topic. Construct a triangle ABC. Construct a triangle ABC in which AB is equal to 5.8 centimeter. Okay, AB is equal to, AB is what? Its base. And one base angle as angle B is equal to 60 degree, it is also given in your question. And the sum of the other two sides in that construction BC plus CA. BC plus CA is also equal to 8.4 centimeter. Okay. So dear student, in that type of question, first of all, we draw a line segment AB is equal to 5.8 centimeter. Let's see. We draw a line segment AB is equal to what? 5.8 centimeter. Okay. Now after that, now what is the procedure of that? Now after that, dear students, we draw one base angle is also given in that type of question. Here one base angle is 60 degree. So now dear student, taking B as center and construct an angle, draw or a BX and construct an angle of 60 degree in this way. Okay, 60 degree in this way because of this is the we construct, and you can easily construct an angle of 60 degree with the help of ruler and compasses. Just we discuss about that topic. Now taking B as center and distance equal to sum of the other two sides as 8.4 centimeter. Cuts taking B as center and distance equal to the sum of the other two sides as 8.4 centimeter. Cuts an arc in this way. Suppose that at point D. Suppose this is your distance of 8.4 centimeter. So taking B as center and distance equal to 8.4 centimeter. Cuts an arc in this way, which cuts the previous arc at point D. Okay. Now, look. Now we join AD. We join what? 80. Now, dear student, we construct the perpendicular bisector of the lines segment AD. So, you know that very well what is the process to construct an angle bisector of the any line segment. For that, dear students, first of all, taking AA center and distance equal to more than half of AD. So, cut an arc, pair of arc in both sides of the line segment AB. Save, taking BAD as center and have the same radius equal in that way. Now, we join and produce to some point this. Suppose that this line cuts the ray BX at point C. At point C, now you join, we join AC. This is the our required triangle. This is our required triangle ABC. This is our required triangle, dear students. Okay, let's see once more time. This is one of the most important topic of your chapter, okay, of this chapter. So dear student, please do more and more practices of that type of construction and your examination purpose. This is one of the most important topic, okay. Now let's see once more time, dear students, in that type of construction, first of all, when base, one base angle and the sum of the other two sides is given. In that of question, first of all, you draw the length of its base, that is AB is equal to what? 5.8 centimeter, which is given in our question. Now, dear student, you construct one base angle is given, so you construct very easy one base angle as 60 degree. So, we draw BX as a ray and the angle ABX as 60 degree. And that topic is discussed in previous classes and previous section just a bit. So now what we do? Now taking B as center, okay? In third step, taking B as center and distance equal to the sum of the other two sides as 8.4 centimeter, draw, cuts an arc, which cuts the ray AX at point D. Okay, now we join AD. After that, we construct the perpendicular bisector of the line segment AD. In order to construct an angular bisector and a line perpendicular bisector of any line segment, we take AA center and distance equal to more than half of AD. We cut the pair of arcs in both sides of the line segment AD. Same as taking BA center, DA center and they have the same radius, cut the arcs in the same way. Now we join and produce to some distance which intersect the ray ABX at point C. Now after that we join AC. So here ABC is our required what? Triangle. So dear student, this is the whole process to construct an angle when its base, one base angle and the sum of the other two sides is given. Now dear students, now we discuss the last topic of that chapter. Okay, let's see. Now we discuss about the construction of triangle when its base, one base angle and difference between the other two sides is given. Okay, now dear student, we discuss about the construction of a triangle when its base, one base angle and the difference between the other two sides is given. Now let's see a question and solve. We discuss that topic. Suppose that, dear student, this is also very interesting and easy topic. Let's see. Construct a triangle ABC. Suppose you construct a triangle ABC in which what is given? Base AB is equal to 5 cm. Good. Angle A is equal to 30 degree. Okay. And some difference of the other two sides also is given as AC minus BC is equal to 2.5 cm. Okay. Look. Now what we do? In the same as previous, first we draw the length of its base. Then we construct one base angle which is given in our question. Let's see. So first we draw the base AB as 5 cm. Look, we draw AB as equal to 5 cm. First of all, dear student, we draw the base of the given triangle as AB is equal to 5 cm. Now, after that, we construct its base angle as 30 degree. And you know that very well, what is the process to construct an angle of 30 degree with the help of ruler and compasses. So in the same way, we draw ray AX and construct an angle BAX is equal to what? 30 degree. We construct angle AR, that is angle BAX is equal to 30 degree. Now, what we do? Now in next step, dear students, from the ray AX, taking A as center and distance equal to the difference between the other two sides. That difference between the other two sides, that is 2.5 cm. So, dear student, taking A as center and distance equal to the difference between the other two sides, we cut an arc as in this way. Suppose at point D, this is your distance of 2.5 cm. Now, what we do? Now, what we do? Simply we join BD. In this way. Now, after that, we construct the perpendicular bisector of the line segment BD. In going to construct the perpendicular bisector of the line segment BD, first of all, we take as B as center and distance equal to more than half of BD. We cut the pair of arc in this way. Same as taking BD as center and distance have the same radius, cut the another radius and two distinct point. Okay. Now we join their intersection point of intersection and produce to some distance. Let's see. Produce to some which intersect the previous ray AX at any point C. This is point C. Now dear student, we join BC. We join BC. Now here the required angle is ABC. Okay, so dear students, here if we join BC, this is the required triangle ABC. So this is the process, dear students, when one base angle and the difference between the other two sides is given, then in that condition, dear students, you apply that process to construct that type of triangle. Let's see once more time. In that type of question construction, first of all you draw its base as AB is equal to 5 cm. After that, you construct an angle of 30 degree with the help of ruler and compasses, which we discussed in previous topic. In this way, now taking A as center and distance equal to the difference between the other two sides, which is 2.5 cm, you can cut an arc at D. Now we join BD. Now we draw the perpendicular bisector of BD and we join their point of intersection and produce to some distance, so it intersect the ray AX at point C. Okay, now take point C. Now we join BC. So this is the ABC, our required triangle. Okay, so dear students, now we discuss all the topic of that chapter, and today's class we revise all the topic of which is included in that chapter. Now dear students, your chapter construction is to be completed. Now in next class we discuss about the last chapter, next chapter, that is, which is last chapter also, statistics. Okay, Now first you construct each and every questions of your NCERT exercise based on each topic. Okay, thank you.